Welcome, welcome. The Angry Appliance Repair Person. For the record, you're looking at him. This presentation is going to be about steam dryers. I can't tell you how many customers buy a dryer normally to match the washer. They buy the washer and they get the matching dryer. And then the salesperson says, oh, it has steam. And you're thinking, oh, steam, wonderful. And then you never use it. You have it, you paid for it, but you never push the button. You never use it. So what is a steam dryer? Let's talk about it. So a steam dryer, there are two kinds of steam dryers. Now I admit, from a consumer's standpoint, figuring out which kind of steam dryer you're buying is not easy. You would almost have to look it up yourself or research it yourself if steam really matters to you. Very few people that I have spoken to actually use steam at all. Every once in a while I get a customer that wants to utilize that feature. There are two kinds of steam. There is the mist steam and there's the generator. The mist steam is a cheaper steam dryer. All it does, and I apologize, forgive this terminology, it is just the easiest way for me to say it. You have a water valve and a small tube that just leaks or pisses the water into the dryer very slowly. And the heat from the dryer makes it steam. You get very little water. The steam cycle comes on and it puts this little drip of water from this nozzle into the dryer. The heat comes on and it makes steam. It is a very cheap way for the companies to do it. It really doesn't do much, with maybe the exception of taking wrinkles on. It does help with wrinkles. This is true. But other than wrinkles, it really doesn't do much of anything else. All it really does is put a little bit of water by dripping it into the dryer, and the heat from the heating element or the gas burner, depending on which dryer you have, will heat that water up to steam and try, I stress that word, to help eliminate wrinkles. That is the most common kind I've seen. Now, there are dryers out there that are more expensive that have steam generators. A steam generator is a different thing. That actually generates the steam itself and then ejects the steam into the dryer. Now, supposedly, what that is supposed to help accomplish is if you have a piece of clothing like this shirt, okay? Oh, I have a little stain, yeah, but so this shirt here, let's say I have a little stain here. That little stain that is on my shirt, if I put that into a steam dryer that has a generator in it, guess what? It's probably still going to be there. So if your clothes are dirty, putting it in there isn't really going to help. But if you have a shirt like this, and you just were at work, and you wore the shirt, and you want to wear it again, you can take the shirt off, put it in the steam dryer on that mode. It will eject steam into the dryer to refresh that shirt, make it smell a little better, have it be go on and feel cleaner, almost, but not dry cleaning. It is not dry cleaning, but it helps the fabric of the shirt, just refreshes the best one to use, that it refreshes it so you can wear it again. You can't, it doesn't do anything for dirt. If it's dirty, that won't help you. It has to be just something that you want to take off and wear again that same day, but it doesn't need to be washed. The steam generators are much more expensive, and you would have to research to see which one it would be, the mist style or the steam generator style. They are different. The mist style basically doesn't do much more than just with wrinkles. The generator style can actually make the shirt feel fresh, whatever that means, but it can actually make it feel fresh. It'll make it feel more clean. And I've actually seen some brands, I don't know if this exists anymore, but it might, where they actually put a scent into, you have these little cartridges you can buy and insert it into the dryer, and it actually puts a smell. So when you pull it out, you smell lavender or watermelon or whatever you want it to smell like. So I don't know if they make those anymore, but it was a luxury or a gimmick or a feature, whatever word you want to use, that they would try to do to help sell their steam generator dryers. But that is really the two. And as I have said in other presentations, don't spend the money if you're not going to use it. If you're going to use the steam that you think you want to try to stop wrinkles, or you can put a shirt in there, a thin shirt like this, that's clean, so you can rewear it. Buy it. But don't buy it if you're not going to use it. You're just spending that money for nothing. One minor detail. Steam and dryer sheets really don't mix. Don't use a steam feature and a dryer sheet. It can actually cause the dryer sheet to fall apart. I have seen particles on clothing from that, and I have seen almost stains that come, depending on the kind of dryer sheet it is, especially the scented ones. They will actually leave a stain on the clothes from the steam feature. Don't use a dryer sheet if you are using a steam on your dryer. Okay, the senile thought each week. I could almost put this thought into what I call my feature presentation, but this is an opinion. And as I have said in previous, claim your opinions. Make my mother happy. Claim your opinions. This is my opinion. A lot of customers think that they do not want to overuse the appliance. Don't use it too much. I want it to last. They think that if they use the appliance too much, they won't get enough life out of it. 25 years ago, I would have agreed, possibly. Appliances were different. There was more metal motors. There were more bearings. There were more bearings that could be oiled. There were a lot of different things that appliances used back then that maybe if a motor could be oiled, it would last you longer. But those days are gone. The newer appliances are mostly plastic. They use DC motors. They do not have oiled bearings like we used to have. It is just, it basically works better if it is run routinely, is the word I like to use. So I can't tell you how many times I would go to a home to service a dishwasher, as in this example, and the lady says to me, well, I only use it 4 times a year. That's it. I only use it 4 times a year. And I went to use it this one time, and I haven't used it for 4 months, and it just hums. The motor got so tight from lack of use, it got stuck. Sometimes I can free that motor, and sometimes I can't, and the motor has to be replaced or a new one purchased. So you want to use the appliance. Letting it sit for long periods of time, I'm not talking a week here, I'm talking more like a month or longer, is not good for these new appliances. In my opinion, they need to be used regularly. I tell my customers that you want to use your washer, your dryer, your dishwasher at least once a week. Keep the motors moving, because there are DC motors in there, not AC motors. There are no oil, there's no lubrication. You want to keep them going. You want to keep them moving. So this is something of the past, where 20, 25 years ago, I might have agreed with that. Today, I don't. Use the appliance at least once a week. Keep it moving, so it will hopefully give you the average 7 to 10 years of life on that appliance. And as always, we thank you for spending some of your day with us.